stuff will go this way. You know, that these two motions will end up getting combined in this little area. They will bang into each other and share each other's pressure. And a little bit of rub off of a little bit of this will rub off on a piece of that, and they'll hit again, and a little bit of this will rub off on a piece of that, and they'll combine each other's motion and create a new motion. And I don't need the mathematics to tell me that's what it's not integral or essential to understanding the concept that this is a motion, that it has a vector, that this is a vector, and to do it without, I don't have to have V of 1 and V of 2 and V of 1 and V of 2 and do all that. I don't have to have that. And I'm certainly not
night.
Completely made up. They didn't go out in space and measure the constant. They didn't measure some constant that turns out when you multiply the two and divide by the square root or whatever, you end up with the speed of light. That didn't happen. They didn't discover something that's half the speed of light or something else that's half the speed of light. No, they created mathematical equations that were incomplete in the sense that they weren't accounting for the fact that it's both electricity and magnetism by their understanding, and that the two had to always be added up to a complete picture, and that's why you needed these two constants. But you don't need the two constants, because the two constants are really representations of one constant. But again, you don't answer any of my questions, right? I mean, I've stated that math is just a formalization of what we already know. We observe something, we observe this relationship, and we can turn it into mathematics and understanding this has motion in one dimension, this one has motion in another dimension, and that dimensional motion can be translated into a third motion, okay, that's going to be based on averaging it out, a combination of those two by how much time they have to mix. So the faster they're going, lots of things will decide exactly how much of the mass will end up going in that direction. So yes, you can write a mathematical equation to explain what you've already observed. It's a formalization. It's formula. It's taking something that you have observed, the relationship. The slit creates does something. If I make it narrower and wider, I watch it. I see it do it. And I write a formula to describe what it's doing. That's not exactly telling you something you didn't know. So this is just, you're just saying that physics is math. I'm saying this isn't math. Okay, your car going this way and a car going that way is not some mathematical equation. They're real things, real events. The fact that it's a deterministic universe based on elemental functions, yes. But do you think they've gotten to the elemental functions?